Welcome to the Catamount Football Show with Coach Matt Land. I'm Bill Mayo, and on this week's show, we're going to take a look back at the North Atlanta game and also preview the upcoming contest with the Cass Colonels. So stay right here. We're back with more Catamount football after these messages.
When is the last time you have compared your car, life, or health insurance cost? At Advanced Insurance Strategies, we know your time is valuable. Therefore, we have developed AdvancedInsuranceStrategies.com. You can now go online anytime, anywhere, and get quick and easy quotes for your car, life, or health insurance from respected companies such as Blue Cross Blue Shield of Georgia, Assurant Health, Alliant Health Plans, and Drive Insurance from Progressive. Receive unparalleled customer service from a local insurance agency while using AdvancedInsuranceStrategies.com.
I'm Mike Jones with Carpet Express, and it's time for our annual fall sale. Thursday, September the 24th to Saturday, September the 26th. We're going to have amazing things going on. Got vinyl flooring starting at 99 cents a square yard. Wood flooring starting at 99 cents a square foot. 40 to 50 ounce carpet starting at 69 cents a square foot. Vinyl flooring 15-6 wide. So get to Carpet Express and take advantage of the savings. Two convenient locations, Carpet Express, your hometown floor store.
Have you ever heard the term, your eyes are your expressions, the windows to your soul? But when your eyelids look tired and they start to sag, it will make you look much older than you actually are. There is a simple surgical procedure called a blepharoplasty or eyelid tuck, which can help to rejuvenate and redefine the contours around your eyelids. It will even improve your fields of vision, and a portion may even be covered by insurance. We can help redefine how others see you.
Welcome back to Catamount Football, and Coach Lane, let's talk a little bit about Friday night's game. First off, the atmosphere I thought was pretty neat. I mean,
very neat.
There was a lot of logistical things that had to happen, but just from playing right downtown Atlanta, you see the backdrop of the city, it was kind of a neat experience for our kids, wasn't it?
Like I said, I did not enjoy anything up to arriving at the stadium and actually getting on the field. But then after that, it was great. You know, that is one. It's a very picturesque stadium, just the lights of downtown, yep. and of course that area, Piedmont Park, and everything has really what'd you call it, yuppified?
Yeah, they've yuppified all those
nice homes, and but it was just it was a great environment for football that night. The weather was cool. Somehow we missed that storm. That was coming in, and so it was cool for the kids. And mm-hmm. like I said, just a great, the ambiance was great. And, you know, to speak about the obvious, I didn't feel in any way unsafe.
No, not at all.
And after talking to the authorities there, it was a very isolated incident that really happened more down the street than really around the stadium. But the stadium was first class. The school has really been, along with that whole area, has been modernized. And just, I thought it was a great experience for our kids to see Atlanta, because that's about as, outside of playing at Tech, that's about as downtown as you can get.
That's right. Playing right downtown.
Yeah.
Talk about the game itself. Kind of a sluggish start beginning offensively, very similar to what happened last year. It takes some time to get adjusted to what those guys were doing defensively. They showed us some things that we hadn't seen. But once it got going, we kind of got rolling.
Yeah, my hat's off to North Atlanta and to their coaches. I thought they had a good game plan for us early on, particularly on offense. They really tried to take advantage of maybe some of our youth on our offense. But I think once we got settled in, you and Coach Napier, all of our offensive staff, Coach Parks, I really felt like we kind of got back to doing what we do. And, of course, you had the guys on Drake had a phenomenal run that really kind of – it really kind of jump-started us. And first three possessions, we turned over twice and then come back on the third one and we fumble it away, and then we score basically the next seven possessions. So, you know, I was very, very happy with our guys. Thought they worked hard. Mm-hmm. Thought they really adapted to so many variables that we couldn't control. Offensively speaking, North Atlanta came out and probably tried to do what a lot of people will try to do over the year, spread our defense out and maybe isolate on some of our smaller guys inside and really try to kind of run on them, and then once you try to come in and protect them, then they try to hit you on the perimeter. They certainly had the athletes to do that.
Right.
But our defense, Coach Carpenter, Coach Thompson, Coach Lawless, all the group, Coach Bennett, and Coach Reagan did an outstanding job of kind of just coaching up position by position. And to their credit, Coach Carpenter, we're getting back in the car, and he said, you know, there's the difference in technology. He said that sideline kit that we talked about last week, he said it probably was the difference in us making some adjustments in the first quarter as opposed to making them in the second half.
Mm-hmm.
He said being able to see it in real time.
Absolutely. That makes a huge difference for us. Kicking game was outstanding.
Yeah, you know,
young fella kicking the ball.
Amazing.
7-8 yards deep in the end zone.
Yeah, I mean, that really is amazing. We bring in Ivan Mora, and Ivan does just an outstanding job. Got an opportunity because of some situation before the Calhoun game. And, you know, I'm excited to see what he's going to do with it. I mean, he certainly brings a different dimension when basically every single kick is in the end zone. You know, what you lose on maybe some directional stuff, if you get it in length and you don't have to return it. Coach Carpenter, I think it was either Coach Carpenter or Coach Tarpenter, said after the game, said, man, to make a high school offense drive 80 yards every single time, that makes a big difference. And then solid in the punting game as well. Good snaps out of Jordan, and Churi did a great job on the field goal. So, like I said, overall, very, very pleased with our performance. Obviously, those are things that we've still got to get better. I mean, we're still dealing with some of those, what I'd call freshman blues. And hopefully we'll keep working those out. And like I said, we were better this week than we were last week. And nothing gets rid of a lost taste better than a win. So
absolutely.
I'm just very thankful for that.
Let's take a quick break, and we'll be back with more Catamount football after these messages.
Happy hump day indeed. O'Charley's Free Pie Wednesday. A free slice with any entree. For a limited time, try our creamy lemon supreme pie. Every Wednesday at O'Charley's.
Life moves fast, and we need to move fast to keep up. But if your internet is slow, it can really slow you down. Isn't it time you tried OptiLink? We have just increased our already fast internet speeds to 25, 50, 75, and 100 megabits without increasing the price. And all of these lightning fast speeds come with 10 megabit upload speeds. OptiLink is your hometown connection for TV, internet, and telephone. Call us today at 706-529-1313.
The Oakwood Cafe is fired up. It's football season once again. We can't wait to see our area teams compete and hopefully make the playoffs. Natalie Dean and our legendary catering staff are standing by to make your tailgate or corporate event a huge success. Do not let this fall pass you by without trying a pancake as big as your head or the best chicken tenders to ever touch your lips. The Oakwood Cafe, where great food is served with a smile.
Welcome back to the Catamount Football Show. We've got our player interview segment. Guys, welcome to the show and introduce yourselves, please.
I'm Darian Hill, number 12, senior. I play running back and fullback.
Dre McCowan, senior, running back, number 29.
All right, Darian, let's start with you. Tell me about being a running back in the Catamount offense.
It's a good opportunity to be a better person, you know, because being a running back, you got the ball pretty much the whole game, sort of.
Yep. Now, one of the things you do, you'll play some fullback and some tailback, and you go out and play in the slot a little bit too. Talk about those different positions and how they're, you know, how the different maybe techniques you're involved with them and what you have to do to be effective at each place.
At wide receiver, you have to know the plays, like know your route and then run it precise, like because if it's too high, you have to go across the receiver's face for the red route. And at fullback, you have to get down your blocks, and running back, you just have to hold on to the ball.
Yeah. You're also starting out of a three-point stance at fullback instead of a two-point stance at tailback, right? Is that a little different for you at times?
Yeah, I get off the ball a lot quicker in a three-point stance and just hit the hole hard.
How about, give me your thoughts on being a senior this year.
It's a good opportunity to step up and be a leader for the team, and I think I can do that.
Very good. Drake, let's talk to you. Same question, because you'll play a little bit of fullback and you'll play mostly tailback, but talk about those two positions and your thoughts on them.
Well, they're very different positions. Fullback, you have to block for the running back, and so if he scores, basically you score. And so, and then at running back, you just have to hold on to the ball, hit the holes, and just cut at the right time.
Yeah. Talk about your 88-yard touchdown run Friday night.
The line did a good job of blocking. I just saw a hole and just went. It was just big, wide open.
Yeah. What did you think about the environment we played in Friday night? It was pretty neat, wasn't it?
Yes, it was a big stadium, great opportunity to show what I can do on that field.
How about you, Darren? What did you think about the setup down there?
It was fun playing in the big city with the city in the background.
Yeah, it was pretty good, wasn't it? So, Drake, one more question for you. Give me your thoughts on the same thing, Darren, on being a senior this year. What are you looking forward to? What do you see your responsibilities as?
You just got to step up, be a leader. When somebody doesn't do right, you got to get in their face and get them right. And then you just got to be tough on the younger kids because, you know, one day they'll be up there and they'll understand how we feel.
One thing I like about you guys is y'all are very unselfish. It seems like it doesn't matter who scores a touchdown. You guys are happy for each other, right?
Yes.
Talk about kind of the closest of your group.
We have a lot of good chemistry together, like running back dinners, and we like good friends on and off the field.
We played with each other through middle school, so that chemistry can roll on, keeps rolling.
Yeah, you can see it and tell that it's sincere. You guys are really happy. It doesn't matter who scores, does it?
No, sir.
As long as we get in the end zone, right?
Yes, sir.
Good job, guys. Thanks for coming on the show. Stay right here, back with more Catamount football in just a minute.
Like a pro at Performance Sports Academy. Get one-on-one training from former professional and collegiate players, featuring indoor baseball and softball training facilities, ground ball area, 3 pitching mounds, and 4 batting cages. Performance Sports Academy is also available for team rentals. Call 706-537-3169 today and train like a pro at Performance Sports Academy.
Honesty, integrity, and hard work, leadership, quality, and value.
Just a few words to describe the company and people that make up Shaw Industries. Shaw Industries, the world's leading carpet manufacturer, is proud to be a sponsor of Dalton Catamount football. Shaw Industries, where great floors begin.
I'm Charles Hicks Sr.
And I'm Charles Hicks Jr.
At Transformers, we use the latest diagnostics, AC brake and tune-up equipment, and have a complete transmission remanufacturing facility.
Rest assured, here at Transformers, you're getting the best technicians with the latest equipment and the most up-to-date vehicle repair data on all foreign and domestic automobiles.
Don't just trust anyone with your automobile. Come to Transformers Transmission and Complete Auto Repair Specialist.
Well, we can make it shift, we can make it cold, we can make it stop, and we guarantee we can make it go.
Back to Catamount football, continuing our player interviews. Guys, welcome to the show. Introduce yourselves, please.
I'm Jesus Rodriguez, senior, 63, defensive lineman.
I'm Nick Faulkner, I'm a junior, number 98, defensive end.
All right, guys, thanks for coming on the show.
Thank you.
Jesus, let's start with you. Tell me about, now you're not a typical, when somebody looks at you, you don't think you're a typical defensive lineman. You're not one of those big hulking guys. Talk to me about playing defensive line, and I know you match up against some really big offensive linemen.
Well, first off, you have to go ahead and swallow that pride of that you're not the biggest dude, and you got to feel like the biggest dude. But playing on the line is a whole different experience, just especially when you are kind of set to a standard and you have to kind of raise the bar even though you're a little bit smaller. But playing, you just got to keep your technique and you're good to go.
What do you do when you match up against some 300-pound guy? I mean, what kind of, talk about the technique. Maybe you might be a little different than if it's a smaller offensive lineman.
Depending on how they line up, you know, if they have a big hole or not, or if it's tight splits, really it's just about low man wins.
Mm-hmm. I think that's a great way to put it. That's a great way to put it. As long as you keep your technique and stay low, you got a fighting chance against some of those big times, those big guys. How about fighting off a double team? That's one of the toughest things you guys have to do.
Ooh,
it can be a challenge, right?
Yes, sir, it can be. It can be, like I said, though, low man wins. Right. But yeah, double team is a pretty tough one.
Talk to me about the defense Friday night. You guys got a shutout. That's always a big accomplishment, big deal. I know it means a lot to the defense. It means a lot to our team.
Yes, sir. Well, the shutout Friday night is just it's a very big, very – it's hard to put into words, especially whenever you're a sophomore and a junior and the seniors get a shutout. It's like, oh, you know, they got their shutout. But then you could step up to the next level as a senior, and it's like, whoa, you got your first shutout as a senior. And it's like a whole new experience and a new feeling.
I know you take your role as a senior on the team and a leader very seriously. Kind of give me your thoughts on that.
Well, my leadership, I felt, didn't start when I stepped up as a senior. I felt more as if it stepped up when, you know, I had to take place for another senior who got hurt last year. But stepping up as a senior never really meant that I'm automatically a leader. It kind of started from the past and worked my way up. And now as a senior, I just kind of want to continue the role and set the bar for the younger guys when they get up there.
Very good. Nick, let's talk to you. I'm going to ask you one of the same questions because you're taller, but you're not, and you're out there playing on the edge against some big old offensive tackles.
Yeah.
Talk to me about that.
Well, most of the time I'll have to, like, read the tackles. Like, I don't really know what they're doing by the body, like, the way they're set up.
Explain what you mean by read. Yeah, talk about that a little
bit. The way they're set up, like, they'll have more pressure on their hand or something. I'll know it's run play or they're off their fingertips. It's a pull or something. I can read their feet also.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's how I do it. And you have to stay low with those, drive you out of there.
Right.
Keep contained on the rush.
You've seen some big offensive tackles already, and we'll see some more as the season goes on, I'm sure, right?
Yes, sir.
So talk about your job as a defensive end. What are your responsibilities? What's the main thing that you're asked to do?
The main thing I'm asked to do is keep contained. Like, you can't let them get outside of you. You know, squeeze the tackles and when they block down and stuff.
Explain what you mean by somebody that maybe doesn't understand football when you say squeeze the tackle.
Like, if the tackle will block down to hit the defensive tackle, you have to push him down there, make the hole smaller.
Right, because you think they're going to come running underneath right there, and you're going to squeeze down and keep them out of that hole, right?
Yes, sir.
How about your views on Friday night at playing downtown?
That was fun. I liked it. It was a big stadium, you know, right beside the city. It's different because I had a game right before. I'd never been in that situation before.
It's kind of a neat environment, wasn't it?
Yes, sir.
All right, guys, thanks for coming on. Did a great job. Look forward to seeing you play this Friday night against Cass.
Thank you so much.
Stay right here. Back with more Catamount football in just a minute. We'll be right back. Welcome back to the Catamount Football Show, and we are on location today at the practice field at Dalton High School. We've got Coach Bill Napier. Coach, thanks for coming on the show.
Sure.
So talk a little bit about this year's offense. I know fans have seen through the first couple of games, certainly a big transition from last year. We've got a new quarterback or quarterbacks and a young offensive line. Talk about how you kind of started building the offense around what we have now.
Well, where we got a lot of depth is in the skill positions. We've got numerous running backs and receivers that are really talented. Obviously, we lost Zeke Cobb in the first game, which was a tremendous loss. But, you know, we've just got to put that behind us and move on. You know, we knew that we'd be young on the O-line and that we'd have some growing stages and growing pains and those kinds of things. But I've been really pleased with them, the progress they're making. You know, three games into it now, you know, we're about where we should be, I think. And, you know, first and foremost, you know, I work with the quarterbacks, and we have three or four of those guys that are really a pleasure to work with. Jace Chastain has played the most snaps to this date. But we've got four really good kids.
I think one of the things we've seen in practice from the different quarterbacks is they all do different things well. They have different skill sets. Kind of talk a little bit about that, about you know, each one of them and what their skill sets are.
Okay, well, Jace is big and fast, so he's what everyone's looking for. And he's obviously very capable of doing a lot of things. You know, he's an option quarterback. He's a throwing quarterback. When he gets out on the corner, he's a threat to run, and that's something that defensive coordinators hate.
And plus, he's a senior too, which adds a little into the mix. Physically mature and.
Yes, yeah. Yes, he does look very physically mature, and he is, and he's got a good portion of experience from starting part of the season as a sophomore and being injured that year.
Right. And then we've got some young guys that are lining up back there.
Right. We put Harrison Hughes in at North Atlanta, and he played lights out and just was, you know, virtually 12 out of 13 or something like that as far as his percentage. Didn't miss a pass. Hit some plays that got called back on penalties that won't show up in the stats. Then we played JP, and JP's very talented. He was our best 7-on-7 quarterback this summer, and has had a real good preseason and early season. He did miss our Northwest scrimmage with a concussion, and we hated to have that happen because we really needed to get him some snaps then. But he got some snaps Friday night at North Atlanta, unfortunately, with the running clock.
Yep.
It didn't last long. And, of course, you and I both hate that.
Yep, worst rule in high school football.
And then, of course, Chandler. Chandler's, you know, just a good, solid quarterback. Doesn't beat you. Has really improved on his arm strength. Very smart kid. You know, just a pleasure to work with.
And all three of those kids are sophomores.
Right.
So that's a great problem to have is you got three guys that are all pretty talented. They're lining up at quarterback.
We'll deal with it.
Right. Talk a little bit about your expectations for the rest of the season for the offense and what you'd like to see the offense kind of grow into.
Well, you know, they got a lot to live up to when it comes to trying to match last year, but we're 2-1, looks like we were last year. There's not that much difference in what we've done up to this point that last year's team did. So we're trying to ride people like Andrew Williams, who is a very good player. Every time I call a play, I think about him and how we can make the play better due to him. Mm-hmm. With that being said, you know, Wyatt has got a lot of experience at receiver. Kyrick's played a lot. Nolan's obviously a baller. When the lights come on, he just starts making plays. That's really what we got with him. We had Drake had a huge night at North Atlanta. Of course, everybody knows Darian had a big night against Scottsboro. Those kind of things we've just got a lot of choices, and I feel like we're blessed. Although we'd like to have more experience on the O-line, we've just got what we've got. It is what it is, and we're working on it. And you and Coach Sparks have done a great job so far.
All right, very good. Well, thanks for coming on the show. And appreciate visiting with you. I know this is not your favorite thing to do, is be on TV, so we like having you on here. Okay. Stay right here. We'll be back with more Catamount football in just a minute.
When is the last time you have compared your car, life, or health insurance cost? At Advanced Insurance Strategies, we know your time is valuable. Therefore, we have developed AdvancedInsuranceStrategies.com. You can now go online anytime, anywhere, and get quick and easy quotes for your car, life, or health insurance from respected companies such as Blue Cross Blue Shield of Georgia, Assurant Health, Alliant Health Plans, and Drive Insurance from Progressive. Receive unparalleled customer service from a local insurance agency while using AdvancedInsuranceStrategies.com.
I'm Mike Jones with Carpet Express, and it's time for our annual fall sale. Thursday, September the 24th to Saturday, September the 26th. We're going to have amazing things going on. We've got vinyl flooring starting at 99 cents a square yard. Wood flooring starting at 99 cents a square foot. 40 to 50 ounce carpet starting at 69 cents a square foot. Vinyl flooring 15-6 wide. So get to Carpet Express and take advantage of the savings. Two convenient locations, Carpet Express, your hometown floor store.
Have you ever heard the term, your eyes are your expressions, the windows to your soul? But when your eyelids look tired and they start to sag, it will make you look much older than you actually are. There is a simple surgical procedure called a blepharoplasty or eyelid tuck, which can help to rejuvenate and redefine the contours around your eyelids. It will even improve your fields of vision, and a portion may even be covered by insurance. We can help redefine how others see you.
All right, Coach Lane, let's take a look at the highlights from the first half of the game Friday night versus North Atlanta. We playing on turf. There's a great shot Brandon got of the
absolutely
kind of the backdrop of what you saw if you were on the field or sitting in the stands.
It truly had a college-esque type feel, a Saturday night feel. And, of course, our guys were so excited about, that's a great surface, but at the end of the day, it came down to the game. Defense did an outstanding job pressuring their quarterback. Quarterback, while one of the smaller players, is probably the best athlete. Had an unbelievable amount of speed and ran the offense pretty well. But as you can tell, our defense, like I said, they tried to come back and get us inside, then go outside, inside, outside.
Comes back on the field, the offense, toss sweep. There's Darian Hill leading and kicking out, and Drake getting a nice gain, but just kind of struggle here in the first couple of possessions to get something going.
Great kick right here, literally flipped the field. 62-yard punt in the air. That's pretty doggone good for a freshman. We'll take that.
Absolutely.
Really pins them back and takes a little bit of their perimeter game away, so they wound up having to run the inside zone on us. Tried to flood down the boundary here and just try to get us to overcommit. Great job here by Jake Myers. Jake played a solid game the other night for us, as well as Travis Nielsen.
Got another look at it there.
Yeah. So pins them down deep. Of course, we smell blood in the water when you get that close, so we go after it. Get a high shank punt. Tyler Nolan just kind of does what he does best. Just gets as many yards as he can.
Terrific field position. The ball's on the 19-yard line. Belly play, and it's hard to say if he was down or not. It was close. I mean, he hit the ground, the ball came out, and they ruled it a fumble.
Once again, great job by Jake Myers and Matt Cook. Had another solid night, and right there, Jace, double duty right now. Just comes up, literally just stays on the field. Comes off during the break to punt or whatever and gets his rest. So good job there. Comes back right here, forces the ball down the middle. Of course, Maddox Houghton is playing just unbelievable for us right now, free safety. Winds up getting a couple interceptions throughout the game.
Come back on offense. Good throw and catch right there to Tyler. Good protection. Jace does a nice job of sticking it right in there. Moves us down to about the 20. Good job.
That's really where Jace is at his best, is on a rollout. Well, gives him an opportunity to get on the corners.
Comes a trap to Drake.
That's a big boy run right there.
That was a good run by Drake.
As all those squats from
good
Coach
job
Thompson.
By the guys up front. That was actually a power play. It wasn't trap. It was a power play.
And then Sharuri Hatanda comes in. Marshall Phillips holds. Kicks off into the end zone, puts the ball at the 20. Once again, a great job right there. Travis Nielsen. Travis is really playing some good football for us right now. Great job backside pursuit by Tucker Sumner. Good job front side. Faulkner shutting it down and forcing it back inside. Once again, great job by Jason Mack Cook coming in making the play right there. You'll see it right here. They take the reads, takes them right to the ball. Good job.
Matt brings a different dimension to our defense. He's got some speed at that linebacker spot.
Absolutely. So we force them into a punt, but they pin it down deep.
Nice job of getting the ball off the goal line. First, kind of the first goal is to get a first down, and this was even better than getting a first down.
That's right. That's 80, exactly right.
88-yard run. So first play, we had about a 10-yard run, set us up on first down, and then we run the trap here and – see, a great job,
By Rashawn.
Sean Mack and by Davis Looper. At this point, we neglected to mention this, Caden Stokes had gotten hurt, had an upper arm injury,
and he's
out for a while. And so Davis, who had been playing anyway, came in and did a nice job at playing right guard for us.
Absolutely. Well, once again, get a great kickoff. They tried to return it and wind up catching it and running out of bounds. Once again, good job there by our defense. Matthew Howe played solid for us the other night. He's been finding a little bit of tonsillitis and did a good job forcing those guys into kicking the ball and
getting draw play. 20. Good tough run by Drake right there. Guy 68 was a
he was a handful.
Yeah, and there's another trap. Touchdown. That's Darian.
We could have ran that pretty much all night.
Well, yeah, they just charge straight up field. They're a great team to trap because they come running up field. And that's exactly what you want a team to do, and it just opens the door for them right there at fullback position.
And Darian, back to what you told me in your conversations earlier, that shows his versatility,
right.
Being able to go back and forth and put his hand down, as you were saying. Once again, kickoff right here by Ivan Moore, and just a phenomenal kick down to the 4-5-6 yard line. Good pursuit right here by Mikael Alexander. And, of course, Fromm does an outstanding job. Colton Fromm coming in making a great play there. And that's a good thing Max is a baseball player. That was one of those center field Willie Mays
basket catches.
That's right. But that brings his – he has two in this game, so he's now leading the state with 5 interceptions.
Jeez.
So that's something to have the state – all classification leader last year in Jordan McKinney, and then turned around this year in Maddox House. So testimony there to Coach Thompson how well he's doing with those guys.
Coming back on offense again, Ritz running the trap again. Little swing pass here to Tyler.
We got Harrison Hughes in at quarterback at this point.
Got a fortuitous bounce right there. That thing.
That don't happen a lot.
No, not to us especially. Yes, young fella Harrison Hughes in at quarterback, doing a great job. I think he was 5 for 5, right?
5 for 5, yeah.
Didn't have
just under 100 yards, yeah. Yep. And one of our new guys here, Keandre Foster, moved in over the spring and came out, and it's great to get him in the game. And, of course, he's making the most of an opportunity right now with Keith Adams hurt.
Good trap block by Diego Campos there. Sprung that for a touchdown. So we're up 28-0. Oh, my goodness.
That's that. Oh, did I just really do that?
I think I was talking to lineman. I missed that Friday. I did not see that.
Well, they certainly didn't see that coming either, yeah. I don't think so. Allows us to really kind of pin our ears back right here. And once again, this little guy shows his athleticism. And so we wind up forcing him into punt.
There's Harrison again hitting Tyler on a just a little bubble screen. Fake punt here. It was 4th and about 10. And Jace, you can just see, just turns on the Jets.
Yeah.
I mean – blocked up real good.
No.
I mean, they got angles, and Jace just eliminates the angles.
Yeah, when you've got speed, that makes a big difference. So great job right there. And great job. That's something that we call, and so it's good to see those guys be able to make that on the
– There's Keandre on the trap again. There's Neff down there trying to block somebody. Getting after
that's
him.
That's right.
Good throw to Tyler right in the middle of the field. Good protection by the offensive line.
I thought Coach Napier did a good job really kind of spreading around all the different guys this week with our play calling. Literally every one of our skill guys, even including our tight end, had a touch this week.
And there it is right there.
Absolutely.
There's Wyatt Irwin on a touchdown pass. Nice job of him by going in and running just a little post route and getting his body in between the defender and the ball. And
great patience by Harrison, waiting for him to clear that number 44, though.
Yep, absolutely.
And putting it in a tight window.
Good throw and catch.
Good snap, good hold, good kick. So 35-0 with 43 seconds left.
We'll be back with the running clock highlights of the second half in just a minute.
Might as well put the rest of the week in cruise control. O'Charley's Free Pie Wednesday. A free slice with any entree. For a limited time, try our creamy lemon supreme pie. Every Wednesday at O'Charley's.
Life moves fast, and we need to move fast to keep up. But if your internet is slow, it can really slow you down. Isn't it time you tried OptiLink? We have just increased our already fast internet speeds to 25, 50, 75, and 100 megabits without increasing the price. And all of these lightning fast speeds come with 10 megabit upload speeds. OptiLink is your hometown connection for TV, internet, and telephone. Call us today at 706-529-1313.
I'm Mike Jones with Carpet Express, and it's time for our annual fall sale. Thursday, September the 24th to Saturday, September the 26th. We're going to have amazing things going on. We've got vinyl flooring starting at 99 cents a square yard. Wood flooring starting at 99 cents a square foot. 40 to 50 ounce carpet starting at 69 cents a square foot. Vinyl flooring 15-6 wide. So get to Carpet Express and take advantage of the savings. Two convenient locations, Carpet Express, your hometown floor store.
I'm Charles Hicks Sr.
And I'm Charles Hicks Jr.
At Transformers, we use the latest diagnostics, AC brake and tune-up equipment, and have a complete transmission remanufacturing facility.
Rest assured, here at Transformers, you're getting the best technicians with the latest equipment and the most up-to-date vehicle repair data on all foreign and domestic automobiles.
Don't just trust anyone with your automobile. Come to Transformers Transmission and Complete Auto Repair Specialist.
Well, we can make it shift, we can make it cold, we can make it stop, and we guarantee we can make it go.
The Oakwood Cafe has fired up its football season once again. We can't wait to see our area teams compete and hopefully make the playoffs. Natalie Dean and our legendary catering staff are standing by to make your tailgate or corporate event a huge success. Do not let this fall pass you by without trying a pancake as big as your head or the best chicken tenders to ever touch your lips. The Oakwood Cafe, where great food is served with a smile.
All right, Coach Lane, we're going to look at the second half highlights, and they were in real time. We had a running clock the entire second half, not just the fourth quarter. And to me, this is the worst rule in high school football.
There's your one that was 6 yards deep right there with Ivan. So great way to start out. Once again, get good pressure up front. Great job there. Great pursuit. And you look at these guys on film. They've got good athletes. That's certainly not their problem. Good job there. We've got to run through that tackle, Maddox. Good job there by Jake Myers, though, and those guys coming in there. Good pressure here by Matt Cook, kind of flushes him out. And when you're up 45-0 or 30, whatever it was at that point, they're not going to give you a fumble on that right there. And then right here, This may be one of the greatest athletic plays I think I've ever seen. And if we had slow motion, this is one that you could really stop the DVR and go back and look. He literally goes up and over this receiver and just takes it out of his hands. And it was phenomenal. Of course, that's number five on the year, 5 in 3 games. Good to see the excitement, though, and see those guys getting excited.
Absolutely. Now I got J.P. Ty in at quarterback. Nice job of avoiding some pressure and finding Tyler. Tyler was busy catching the football. And a lot of you notice a lot of his catches are right in the middle of the field.
Great job by Andrew Williams right there. Just a great job. Yeah, Tyler's a fearless guy. He'll kind of go in there and he'll catch it anywhere. It doesn't matter. And
quarterback sneak.
The vulture play. You know what we call that? Vulture on one. So.
Yes, absolutely. So now it's 42-0, and this game is being played in real time.
That's right. Another good one right there, deep. Once again, just great to see a young man taking the most of an opportunity. Come in right there, and of course, Jordan McKinney, after last year, really this kind of became a year where we're not going to throw to him. So that's the reason why his count's down.
So they throw it 15, and Harrison just.
That's right. That's right. Good job of Phil. Yep. I think his dad told me good thing that the field's not 105 yards because he'd got caught. So, you know, great read right here, though. He comes off of an inside pick and steps right in front of the receiver, makes the catch. And I don't know who he's pointing at right there with that thing.
I like how he's got the ball high and tight, though. That's he's right. Getting that ball high and tight.
He's excited. He's a sophomore, and it's good to see him get that play. Good job there.
So there's the final score, 49-0. Oh, here we go.
We hold on.
Yeah, I thought we were.
Well, you know, there was another one there that Harrison could have. Come back here. We still got just a few of our older guys in, not all of them, but we've got a few. That's something big that we talk about is shutout. And, right. You know, that's the reason why, you know, you'll see us put these other guys in here in just a moment. Good job right here by Tyler. Just getting what he can and getting up the field. We had a holding penalty. So it was brought back.
So now we got our second group of offensive linemen in the game. There's J.P. rolling out.
To Lath Land.
Making his first official
That's right.
varsity catch.
That's right. He's good now to see. Officially in the record books. Now.
That's right.
So, great job right there, though. Good route. Way to get the ball and get vertical. You know, that's one thing we talk about. Just catch and get what you can. You know, get the ball out of bounds. We'll get it back on the line.
End up having to punt.
Get a good punt right here with a good roll. And somehow, of course, we did touch it there. So we should mention Austin Mills is really one of our special teams captains. He's able to really get down the field and really helps us get a lot of – oh, my. It was throw to 15, not
– Yeah, DBs had their hand on the balls.
Yeah.
All night on the football.
And then right there to end the game, Jordan McKinney makes the – makes the interception. They actually did give that to him. So, four turnovers on the night. It's great to have, great to get out of Atlanta with a win, and certainly proud of those guys after a good week of work. Actually, 2 good weeks of work.
Absolutely.
Train like a pro at Performance Sports Academy. Get one-on-one training from former professional and collegiate players, featuring indoor baseball and softball training facilities, ground ball area, 3 pitching mounds, and 4 batting cages. Performance Sports Academy is also available for team rentals. Call 706-537-3169 today and train like a pro at Performance Sports Academy.
honesty, integrity, and hard work, leadership, quality, and value. Just a few words to describe the company and people that make up Shaw Industries. Shaw Industries, the world's leading carpet manufacturer, is proud to be a sponsor of Dalton Catamount football. Shaw Industries, where great floors begin.
I'm Charles Hicks Sr.
And I'm Charles Hicks Jr.
At Transformers, we use the latest diagnostics, AC brake and tune-up equipment, and have a complete transmission remanufacturing facility.
Rest assured, here at Transformers, you're getting the best technicians with the latest equipment and the most up-to-date vehicle repair data on all foreign and domestic automobiles.
Don't just trust anyone with your automobile. Come to Transformers Transmission and Complete Auto Repair Specialist.
Well, we can make it shift, we can make it cold, we can make it stop, and we guarantee we can make it go.
Back on Catamount Football, and Coach Lane, let's talk a little bit about this game with the Cass Colonels this week. We're going down to Bartow County to take on these guys, and they're always a tough team to play. I mean, they're well coached and got a lot of fight in them, don't they?
I think you said the two things, that they're well coached, and I think the other thing is they're very athletic. You and I traveled all the basketball games, and you kind of get a really good idea of what kind of athleticism a team has when you kind of go into that. Those environments, and there's no pads on, there's no cleats on.
Right,
I mean, they're out there in a tank top. You see what? They have a very, very athletic team. Very athletic in their line. Got great size in the line. Their returning starter at quarterback is a tall kid, about 6'4". Got a great live arm. You kind of look at all the little pieces that they have, and they're a very, very good football team. They've played well against the two teams so far. They played well against Cass, played well against Cartersville in their scrimmage, and then this week played Forsyth Central, which is kind of a different game altogether because you're playing the old Wishbone team. So not probably a lot will get off of their film. But outside of that, very athletic and very, very disciplined.
Multiple on offense, a little spread, a little eye. Little bit of everything, right?
Yeah, I think they kind of dab in a little bit of everything to kind of find out which one's going to work, and then they're going to ride that horse until you stop it, and then they swim. I mean, they're really a lot like us when it comes to an offense. I wouldn't say they're really one type of system. I think predominantly they want to be spread because that puts more athletes on the field. But at the end of the day, if they're able to run it down your throat, I think they'll wind up doing that.
Defensively, they've been a 3-5 team, but they've shown a little four-man front, so we'll certainly expect some of both on Friday, and that's
certainly what we do.
We've become used to that now, so the guys will have them ready to block either front, and maybe something even different. So.
Well, Coach Hughes, the head coach, is the old defensive coordinator, so he spends a lot of time over there tinkering and all that, and I know that he'll look back at what they've done in the past against us and whatever worked, then he'll certainly want to spend more time on that than probably some other things. So.
Want to invite everybody to go down.
That's
to Cass,
right. Great down, stadium.
7:30. Yeah, it is a very nice setting.
Very nice stadium.
Easy to get to.
Right off the interstate.
Absolutely. So let's take a quick break. We'll be back with more Catamount football in just a minute.
When is the last time you have compared your car, life, or health insurance cost? At Advanced Insurance Strategies, we know your time is valuable. Therefore, we have developed AdvancedInsuranceStrategies.com. You can now go online anytime, anywhere, and get quick and easy quotes for your car, life, or health insurance from respected companies such as Blue Cross Blue Shield of Georgia, Assurant Health, Alliant Health Plans, and Drive Insurance from Progressive. Receive unparalleled customer service from a local insurance agency while using AdvancedInsuranceStrategies.com.
Have you ever heard the term, your eyes are your expressions, the windows to your soul? But when your eyelids look tired and they start to sag, it will make you look much older than you actually are. There is a simple surgical procedure called a blepharoplasty or eyelid tuck, which can help to rejuvenate and redefine the contours around your eyelids. It will even improve your fields of vision, and a portion may even be covered by insurance. We can help redefine how others see you.
All right, Coach Land, we've come to the end of the week three show, which is hard to believe. We've played three football games.
Third of the season.
A third of the season.
It's really crazy.
Third of the season. But let's, again, the support that we always get, that's, you just can't thank people enough, right?
I was talking to one of the stadium officials down in North Atlanta, and he said so far that we're probably one of the largest crowds that they've had travel into that stadium. And you got to think, I mean, that's an Atlanta Public School stadium that serves Atlanta Public Schools. And the game before us was Atlanta Public Schools.
Right.
And we had more people in our stands than both of those teams probably combined. So I think that's a good and a bad thing. It's bad that teams in Atlanta don't have more people that travel with them. But the other thing is how good our fans are. They do a great job of traveling and getting down and of course, just supporting us and being with us the whole game, because you are traveling in to an environment where you're playing in Atlanta with Atlanta officials, and you know our fans are kind of they're the constant wherever we go, and of course our quarterback club did an outstanding job again this week with our charter buses and that Kentucky Fried Chicken for Cross. Those guys, they love that. I think they play for the chicken. That's
absolutely,
that's the old pay for play system. And you know, at the end of the day, just the band going down and traveling and playing at halftime. I mean, you know, there wasn't even that team didn't even have a band. So I just think the whole Dalton experience is just, it's awesome. And you know, and sometimes it takes games like that, and maybe takes regions like this for us to realize how blessed we are to have the fan support, the booster club support, and then all the auxiliaries, whether it's cheerleaders, whether it's the band that goes down and supports us. Very happy for that.
I heard so many comments from people there, from whether it was the Best Academy people or the Therrell people that were playing prior to us, or some of the stadium folks, just about the way our, you know, the kids coming in with their red coats and their ties. People love that, you know. And the quarterback club and our boosters make that possible, because if you had to take a school bus, no way you travel like that.
No, you couldn't.
But being on those charter buses and being able to travel like that, I mean, it really is. You know, you and I had the experience of playing in college, and that is no doubt. I mean, that's how we used to show up. You
absolutely.
Know, when I was at Tennessee.
Absolutely. The experience that Dalton High football provides. I mean, to me, when I went to college, and you, I know the same thing with you. It was a continuation. It wasn't something new. And I'm glad that our guys, first of all, get that opportunity as players. But the other thing is, and this is a testimony to our players, I think they genuinely appreciate it. And the one thing that I always hear, whether we're at Jacksonville State at camp or whether we're talking to the stadium official, you guys are so polite. When you leave, you clean it up. You leave it better than you found it. And the guys carry just really, they represent you guys with such pride and grace and character. And just looking up there, I got a great picture of, or somebody sent me a picture of our guys sitting up in the stands during the earlier game, just, and it's a red block, those red coats on, and with the city lights behind it. So it's just it's a great thing to be a Catamount, for sure.
Absolutely. I was especially proud of the kids, the way they adapt, because it wasn't a normal game atmosphere. You come, you show up, you've got to sit in the stands and, you know, wait before the game.
Wait till halftime.
Right, wait till halftime, get dressed in shifts, warm up over there in the grass. You know, they gave you 20 minutes, and I understand that, because they got to get it rolling.
Oh, absolutely. You'd be there all night.
We've had three different kickoff times now. We've had a 7:30, an 8, and an
8:42.
8:40, whatever time it was. But they adapted, you know, and that's good to see that that they can handle that and adapt and be ready to go.
Well, I don't know if it was you or Coach Carpenter or maybe it's even Coach Thompson that made the comment, and I think this speaks to the mentality of the kids. The Blazers are all great and everything, but you know, Coach Chappell, part of the aura of us putting these jackets on is you're going to work,
right?
And that's what those guys did Friday night. They went to work. They went and you know what we talked about all week: control the things we can control. What can we control? Our effort, and what we do inside that box. Right. Everything outside that, we're subject to what happens, who's right. here, and what teams are there. And so, yeah, they adapted great. They were where they were supposed to be, doing what they're supposed to do. And I certainly don't contribute how slow we started to the adaptability. I think it was more they had a great game plan, and we right. overcame it. So I was very, very proud of our guys and thought they did well.
Let's talk real quick. We're getting ready to get into the meat of the schedule now. It's sub-region play.
That's right.
5-6 weeks in a row of mm-hmm. sub-region play. No more off weeks.
No.
Here we go, right?
It all counts now. Yeah. Now all the marbles. We talk about the three phases of the season. Well, this is kind of second phase. Now this is where everything counts. Mm-hmm. And every game, every film is going to be seen by every team. So as we kind of begin to go through this, you'll begin to see now you don't hold anything in the bag anymore. You pull it out. You do exactly what you got to do and do whatever it takes to win. And like I said, our sub-region has really improved this year. Got some new head coaches. Have some new coordinators as well. So this is going to be a week-to-week deal, and so I'm excited to see how our coaching staff, speaking about adaptation, how do they adapt as we get ready for this, because there's going to be some new schemes that you can't just pull out what you did last year. We're going to have to do some things differently.
Absolutely. It's going to need everybody's support these next
Please.
5 or 6 weeks.
Absolutely.
Well, let's close up the show like we always do and say we'll be back next week, same cat time, same cat channel.
Go Big Red.